Today's how-to, Prepress in Adobe InDesign. Hi, I'm David Dilling from Markzware, and today we're going to show you a few tips on Prepress in Adobe InDesign. And over here on Amazon, when we do a search for Prepress InDesign, we'll see numerous books, including one which I haven't personally checked out myself, but you know, Mr. Burke is well-respected in the industry and pretty affordable as well. Mastering InDesign CS5 for Print Design and Production. And there's more books as well. Here's a newer one, Designing for Print by Charles Conover. Just a few, a couple books, recent ones that might be interesting for you also to check out to help you master the prepress process. Did a search in Google for how to prepress Adobe InDesign, and we got some results, of course. 674,000 to be exact. Let's click on the first one. The first one talks about make sure your version of InDesign is 1.5 or greater. Well, I think Google needs to look at their results in this case a little bit closer. They're talking about PageMaker over here, PostScript, CorelDRAW, QuarkXPress. But what they do mention, which is still important today, just as much as it was then, is to preflight and package native files. And that's something very important for prepress and InDesign, whether you're making a print-ready PDF or sending the InDesign file with your fonts. These are very important tips and tricks. For the package feature, it can even be good just for archiving. Yeah, this is actually a great article, before I quickly show Flightcheck here, on the importance of in-flight, pre-flight, and post-flight in the print workflow. Now, I don't need to be in InDesign, like this file here, this newsletter that's open in the background. I don't even need to have InDesign on my system to check a file with FlightCheck. That's really the beauty. I can just go on the flight strip here and click open, and anything that comes in, so as a secretary or a customer service representative at a printer or prepress shop, or as a advertising intake person at the publisher, or even as a graphic designer, I can first simply just go in and choose a file to check, the file that's come in this example, and FlightCheck does the rest. Tell me what's inside that InDesign file without opening it and going through manually or even choosing some preflight feature inside or in flight. Let's preflight before we take flight, and use FlightCheck to help us with our prepress tasks within Adobe InDesign. The FlightCheck Eagle gathers all details on the files. We get two screens, the results, an overview in plain English, what the problems might be, and the main screen, where we see all the details of the file, good, bad, and otherwise, red being a problem, and blue being a warning. We can tab through this file and see all the different areas. We could even collect the job, or package as they call it in InDesign. The advantage over the FlightCheck package feature to the built-in InDesign package feature is we get everything, even the Adobe Illustrator placed files and files used within the Adobe Illustrator files, fonts and images. Furthermore, we also compress the job. No matter what it is, we'll compress up that folder and we'll give it an X if it fails, or a FlightCheck approved folder if it's fine, giving peace of mind to the next person in your workflow. Hopefully they are preflighting as well. Once again, preflighting can take many forms, and the prepress process of InDesign, it should be done both before you even start the InDesign file by checking your individual graphics and objects. You see on the quality triangle here exactly how important that is in the workflow. You should be then checking in flight inside of InDesign, and you should be pre-flighting outside of InDesign to ensure everything's fine before you create that PDF and go to the post-flight process within a pit stop or Acrobat itself. And there's other tools as well. Even FlightCheck will check the PDF file as well. And we have two totally separate interfaces for PDF and for native files like InDesign or Illustrator or Quark. That's the importance of prepress in InDesign, is that it's a extended process. It is not something that just happens in one place. It happens throughout. Let's go back in the search and let's narrow this down to, say, in the past year. So Google does help us in that respect, and we can now go in and look for relevant pages. Here's an interesting Prepress help one. File naming best practices. Do not use illegal characters such as these. File name should not exceed 25 characters. And we get a bunch of returns over on the community help section run by Adobe themselves. And we have some interesting ones. Prepress Myths by InDesign Secrets. InDesign Secrets, always a great site to check out. CS5, importing other graphic formats. Very important. And here's a good one, preparing PDFs for service providers. But let's click on this importing other graphic formats. InDesign supports a variety of graphic formats, including bitmap formats such as TIFF, GIF, JPEG, and BMP, and vector formats such as EPS. They even support native Illustrator files to be placed in InDesign. However, this is very important because InDesign's Preflight will not check placed vector artwork from Adobe Illustrator natively. Flightcheck will, however, very important tip. It'll also package those as well, and all including fonts in the placed graphics. Very important.
Actually, this is in reply to a forum post over on the Adobe forums on the InDesign section. He mentions, point of this post from the original post was, does package collect Illustrator links? He mentions it's clear the answer is no, at least within InDesign. What I want to show you right now is how Markzware's Flightcheck can actually package that up for you. And I will show that to you right now. You can see I've added to the second page here, in addition to the nice little ad we had here on the first page I used as a test file, I've added in this placed within it. It sees the other files I used on page one, but on page two, it doesn't see the placed images. So, and likely not the fonts either. That's a good question. Research that later. Okay, so now we save this file out, which I've already done, and I go and we'll use Flightcheck and see how what that tells us. Okay, so what does Flightcheck tell us? See here the document being pre-flighted. It'll check InDesign, Illustrator, and package them both, as well as Photoshop, PDF, QuarkXPress, etc. All right, let's take a closer look. All right, so here we see now the images section only, and you'll see all the different images used on, but you'll also notice we have here this little, it's hard to see maybe in this film, but we have here an icon that is Adobe Illustrator, and we see also that there are fonts embedded within the Illustrator file. And if you hover over, you can see what they are, Futura Bold and Myriad Pro Regular. And we get more information on that image if we double-click it. So Flightcheck will see the Adobe Illustrator file is used within the layout, but we also see the actual image that you just saw was placed in that Adobe Illustrator file, and we give a preview. And we can show if there's any fonts used within that. So now, the next part is, let's collect the job so we get all the fonts and images that are used within this InDesign layout, including the Illustrator native file with placed images within that itself and its fonts. Let's collect that entire job with Flightcheck.
All these files, it gives you tips and tricks on if it's importable, most of the time it is, and what the potential problems are. For instance, lossy compression, JPEG encoding, etc. These are all things which Flightcheck can help you check automatically, either individually on the TIFF or EPS files, or once placed within InDesign. The beauty of FlightCheck is it's a standalone process, so you don't need to fumble around inside of an interface to try to find out how to check for it. You just drop the file on FlightCheck, and it'll tell you if your InDesign file is ready for Prepress use or not. Very handy to use on all incoming files, really. Just drop any incoming file or graphic right on FlightCheck, and it'll tell you. Very important Prepress details for printed works: your margin area, your page area, the bleed, and the slug area. There's really so many tips and tricks to do with an InDesign and for Prepress. So our recommendation, just like a good tennis player doesn't necessarily have to be told what to do during the match, he or she will correct their play and their practice outside of the match. And that is what FlightCheck does as a standalone application. It allows you outside of InDesign to quickly ascertain what the problems may be. FlightCheck is a standalone application for Macintosh, now in version 6.80. You can see a full demonstration video here on the markzware.com/products/FlightCheck webpage. FlightCheck is more than 15 years on the market, and it's a de facto standard of preflighting. Your way to prepress and design files. David from Markzware, signing off.